Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. Today is Martin Luther King Jr. Day 2020. Today we celebrate the legacy of this man, but has a dual meaning today, this very special day, January 20th, 2020. Let's explore. Yes, what you're looking at here is a medal. This is the only U.S. Mint product that actually has the face of Martin Luther King Jr. Of course, it has Coretta Scott King as well. This is a medal that was created by an act of Congress in 2004. But there are no coins that show this man who protested and lobbied Congress that essentially led up to the culmination of the Civil Rights Act in 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965. So it's very, very apropos that we honor this man for what he had done. Obviously, as he has fought for the civil rights of minorities, specifically in this case, Black Americans, who for many years were treated essentially as second-class citizens, but at least that they were not recognized for the full citizenship as Americans. And so this, I think, was quite an overdue to further the civil rights of Black Americans throughout the nation here. But what's fascinating about that, and as this medal is this side here, and I think this is where how it ties into today. This is a quote. I suggest that the philosophy and strategy of nonviolence become immediately a subject for study, for serious experimentation in every field of human conflict, by no means excluding the relations between nations. This may well be mankind's last chance to choose between chaos and community. And this is for the Martin Luther King Jr. Center for Nonviolent Social Change. And I think especially when you're talking about social change or the preservation of rights, how important this is. And we'll talk a little bit more about that, because that is how he was able to achieve, I believe, greatness. Even though Martin Luther King Jr. was definitely a flawed man, I certainly disagreed with some of his political viewpoints in terms of what he thought the role of government should be. In fact, some have been theorized that Martin Luther King Jr. Essentially was a communist or was flirting with those ideas. But nonetheless, I think his stand on equal rights for Black Americans and really for all Americans, you know, it's not about the color of the skin, it's about the content of the character of the man or woman. And I think that's crucially foundational. Obviously, these are ideas that most every American certainly, is familiar with today and certainly would agree with. So it's basic. But back at the time when he was fighting for this peacefully, it was not. And so I think would be nice to see a coin with Martin Luther King Jr.'s image on it, just for that alone. Because throughout history, we have different influencers of American history and the way that the nation has evolved and come to right wrongs of the past. And I think that this coin here from the American Numismatic Association's blog, I think this would have been a kind of a cool idea for maybe have it in concert with the circulating cents. But, you know, we talked about how the United States Mint is going to be putting a privy mark on quarters, on W minted quarters, to celebrate the 75th anniversary of the end of World War II. Well, how about a cent that has Martin Luther King Jr.'s image on it? And with the classic memorial design, with the crowd there gathered around the memorial where he gave his famous speech. That would have been a pretty cool idea. And of course, we can see here that there has been some efforts in the Congress In fact, in 2001 and 2004 and in 2013, there was a proposal for this very coin here. And but nonetheless, I think it would be a great idea to have it is co-circulate with the Lincoln cent. Been quite fascinating. But that is the numismatic failure, I think, in some way. But that is really at the mercy of Congress. Some people don't understand that commemorative coins are basically limited to two programs per year, and in those programs, they are made law by Congress and signed by the president. Notwithstanding, let's get back to this particular image here of the nonviolent social change. I think that is certainly is something that should be obviously considered when it comes to protest or rallying. And on this very day, the 20th of January, down in the state of or the Commonwealth of Virginia, there is what's known as Lobby Day. This occurs every year where citizens can lobby their delegates. And essentially, they go to the Capitol and they basically can act as a lobby group. It's the people, it's the connection of the people to the General Assembly there in the Commonwealth. And so it's happening today, that today is special because of the proposals to infringe upon the rights of lawful citizens to keep and carry arms. And these rights are being infringed upon by the newest Democrat elected legislature. And there are some of these proposals that have been set forth have been pretty radical shifts from what Virginia has had in the past. And so this is something that people are gathering by the tens of thousands at this very hour to discuss. And I would encourage, obviously, most Second Amendment supporters are peaceful people. And I would say that it's going to be a peaceful, at least from the last I checked, as they are marching and they're gathering in those areas. It is a peaceful gathering. And but there are some who would want to upset the apple cart, so to speak. And in fact, some may pretend to be Second Amendment supporters, even wearing hats and shirts and banners that propose to be supporters and be in solidarity with those protesting, but they are just masks, wolves in sheep's clothing, there to start trouble. And so it is something that people have to watch out for. That kind of thing has happened in the past. And certainly this is an opportunity to try to make the Second Amendment folks look bad as they do protests. I will or rally in this particular case. Another thing of note that along the Capitol grounds, the way it has been arranged, it's just an area where there are security threats from rooftops around the Capitol there. I've watched some and read some different things about it, that if there was a bad actor on one of those rooftops, it could be another Las Vegas event all over again, with no way out except for one choke point, which is very poorly planned by the governor of the Commonwealth there. I will make note too that though Martin Luther King Jr. was a peaceful protester for social change, a civil rights leader, he himself had applied for a concealed carry permit and knew that, in order to protect yourself, you need to have your firearm just in the case. If he was to be approached, because his life was certainly under threat multiple times during his activity and during his movements there as the civil rights leader, and in the multiple different ways that he has upset the apple cart of the status quo in that area. So, on this Martin Luther King Jr. Day, let us remember Martin Luther King Jr., but also let us stand and remember that we're fighting for our rights in a different way, and the Commonwealth of Virginia is ground zero for it here now. Other states have already have gone beyond And literally, there are places in some states where firearms are totally illegal to own. And so the Second Amendment is under attack today. And I believe that if Martin Luther King Jr. were alive, understanding the threats that he had faced, and obviously what had happened, he was eventually assassinated, did not see the bullet coming. But however, if he had a chance to defend himself, he had a concealed carry permit, and he could have taken out the assassin if he had the chance. So there you have it, and I hope everybody has a wonderful day. And extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for watching. I encourage you to please rate, share, comment, and subscribe.